I'm Dr. Young. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we are going to review the social cost of having some industries dominated by only one firm. Let's start with a quick review. In a perfectly competitive market, many firms supply a total market quantity of Q star and sell it to their customers at the price of P star. Both suppliers and consumers benefit measurably from this trade. For consumers, it equals the orange shaded area called consumer surplus. For producers, it is the blue shaded area called the producer surplus. If those are the only two groups of market actors in this stylized economy, the sum of producer and consumer surplus is the benefit that society as a whole enjoys from this market interaction. You will often see this called social surplus or social welfare. However, a monopolist produces far less compared to the supply in a perfectly competitive scenario and charges a much higher price in order to maximize its profits. The optimal point of production for a monopolist is where the marginal cost of production equals the marginal revenue. So a monopolist will reshuffle the surplus division amongst producers and consumers compared to a market in perfect competition. The consumer surplus, which is the amount a buyer is willing to pay for a good minus the amount the buyer actually pays for it, is equal to area C plus B plus E under perfect competition, the orange shaded area. It shrinks substantially under a monopoly, all the way to area C. The producer surplus, the amount a seller pays for a good minus the seller's cost of providing it, corresponds to the sum of areas A and D under perfect competition. It shifts the sum of areas A and B if the producer is a monopolist. Notice that, relative to surplus division in perfect competition, the monopolist took area B from the consumers. But what happens to areas E and D? Well, in a monopoly, production stops at QM. It does not go all the way to Q star, as in perfect competition. So the social benefit from those last few transactions is now lost. Consumers are worse off because they gave up gains the size of areas B and E. The monopolist is better off comparatively. It loses area D, but that is smaller than what it gains in area B. But society as a whole is suffering because some of the potential gains from this market, areas E and D, are not realized under a monopoly. This is called deadweight loss. Deadweight loss is defined as the fall in total surplus that results from a market distortion, such as a monopoly. We can quantify the deadweight loss by calculating the difference between the social surplus under perfect competition minus the social surplus under a monopoly. When we're dealing with linear demand and supply functions, the deadweight loss corresponds to the area of the red shaded triangle. Here you can see how to calculate that area. Being able to compute the deadweight loss is very important. A regulator might need to compare the loss in social welfare caused by a monopoly to the cost of a regulator intervening. Obviously, a regulator intervenes in order to assess if it is necessary to limit the monopolist's market power. This should help you understand and quantify the cost that society pays when monopolies dominate a given market. Feel free to visit Chegg to see pre-solved examples or ask one of our subject matter experts about specific issues. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.